as a song about how two London policemen got me out of the worst depression I was ever in my life. God bless those men. Well, she walked through the street, feeling part of the crowd. Though she knew at night she'd sleep alone, she used to say, the universe will provide. But that's one hell of a space to call a home. And I still think of her on cold gray mornings, when I'm drinking in a bar called the Royal Exchange, with old Irish men who live in one. As the day wore on, I walked through back streets to the Black Man Bar. Thought about my dear old friend Noel, how he brought me here to say goodbye. That splendid man then left to die. And I cut my hand on an old, old story as I turned the page to see who died. I saw the salt pouring into the wounds of little boys who couldn't cry. It's your life, you're making tracks, but I spent a month alone in the underground. In Marylebone Station in London town. Two policemen stopped and asked if I was okay. I said, I'm working on. And in April time, when the bluebells come, to country lanes that I have known, I see children swimming in an English river. In summer heat they splash and shout. It's your life, you're making tracks. And I dedicate this song to the hours when the power of roses lived in me. With the thorns and with the petals, and with surrender to the honeybee. Thank you. Got a ring on your finger. I see the shining stone gleaming in this deepest winter like an eternity of snow. And I remember this pasture. I saw true lovers confess. Tears are running like two rivers, travelers in their last distress, travelers in their last distress. And no matter where you call, no matter what you do, in your heart, I loved you so. I loved you so. Yeah. And I hear young women laughing as they're driving through warm towns. I hear them talking one to the other, driving with the car roof down. And they turn left at a green light to destinations unknown. I see the rings upon their finger. I see the shining stone and bells upon their toes. And they shall have music wherever they go. And no matter you go, no matter what you do, no, keep a little bit of me in your heart. I loved you so. And I hear the big wheels turning. I hear a little voice in space. I see men counting out money in the crowded marketplace. And I hear ancient women singing in the Outer Hebrides. songs of work and love and ocean, down the salted centuries, down the salted centuries. And no matter where you go, no matter why you do, no, keep a little piece of me in your heart. I loved you so. I loved you so. And there's a wild man at the station on the high snowbound plain, and he stands alone in silence, waiting for the morning train. And I remember this place in a summer afternoon haze, confessions of true love, the promise of that very day, the promise of that very day. Surely some healing is at hand, the very motion of that. And no matter where you go, no matter what you do, keep a little bit of me in your heart. I loved you so. I loved you so. And no matter where you go, no matter what you do, keep a little bit of me in your heart. Keep a little bit of me in your heart. Keep a little bit of me. No matter where you go, no matter what you do, keep a little bit of me in your heart. Keep a little. Keep a little bird. No matter where you go, I loved you so. I loved you so. I loved you so.
Thank you.
Most of your songs seem to rely on storytelling. Then again, they are pretty emotive and personal. How much of yourself do they express?
Well, quite a lot, but I try to write songs which also speak of where I came from in Scotland, my own community, and also put in all the interesting things people tell me when I'm on tour. Whenever I go on tour, people say this funny thing. They say, your life has been so interesting and mine's been so boring. Then they talk about their own life, and to me it's really, really interesting what they say. So I'm just fascinated by the endlessness of human experience and the crazy things that can happen to you. So I try and get that in my songs.
Is there a general lyrical inspiration?
I guess I just love the human voice. When I was very young at school, when I was about 13, I was lucky because I had a teacher who introduced me to the great Russian poetry and the great American poetry. So from an early age, I had these really great poetic voices giving me ideas. And so this is kind of the basis of how I write.
Your fascination with poetry is pretty obvious. Mm. Do you write anything other than lyrics?
I like to write on toilet walls wherever I go. I'm the kind of guy that messes up your toilet with really stupid graffiti. But I write a column each month on my website and try and make it a real proper good piece of work of art. So I'd like to write more than just songs, but I've got so many songs to write at the moment. I just keep on writing songs.
Are you remembering the vocal reverb, Arne? This is a song that started in the Irish city of Belfast. You may have heard of Belfast. She is handsome, she is pretty. She is the belle of Belfast. She is curtain 1, 2, 3. Please won't you tell me who is she? So we were playing in Belfast, and then we had to drive to Dublin the next day. And as we drove out of Belfast, I looked out of the car and I saw walking in the rain a certain kind of man. A man in an old grey coat with a bottle of vodka in his pocket, with no happy home to go home to, no holiday in Greece, no nothing, just a look in his eyes, a bit like this. And I was thinking, where have I seen men like this before? And I thought, oh yeah, I know. Just last week in the English city of Leeds, and in the German city of Hamburg, and in the Scottish city of Glasgow. There's a lot of them about. I even saw one today in Bonn. This is a song for those men, God bless them all. I took a train out of Leeds into Smear and Stain. I saw the city pass by in the shuffling rain. I'm in Huddersfield drinking in the Slover's Arms, and I walk through slush by broken farms. Huddling sheep are turning grey in the cold light of a nothing day. It took me 50 long years just to work out that because I was angry didn't mean I was right. Now I'm sitting in a bar alone with a jukebox playing a terrible song, a really terrible song, Robbie Williams. The bartender says, I see it's you again. I've been drinking deep from a jar of pain. Jar of pain. I remember once I went home like this. Had my mother in tears as I felt her. There's a dying man who lives alone. He closed the door and he turned away. And the tide rushes in on a fatal shore. I can never never get too close to cold. With the glass in my hand and the embers crack, but the fire's gone out and the chimney's closed, and there's a round cheer sticking on my back, on my back. I remember once I went home like this, had my mother in tears and I felt her kiss. Now my mother is heaven bound, and her body lies in unmarked ground. Train out of Leeds in the smear and sand. I saw the city pass by in the shuffling rain. And with chimneys leading to the sea, I got the sound of Sunderland creasing me. Took a jar of pain into the soaking field, and to the lonely sea wall in South Shields, South Shields. I remember once I went home like this, had my mother in tears as I felt her kiss. Ah, now my mother is heaven bound, her body lies in unmarked ground, unmarked ground. And if I was a man, which I am not, standing in a last of rotten snow, I'd fall on my knees and I'd cry out loud to the snowy river and the icy flow. Leads in the smear and stain. I saw the city pass by in the shuffling rain.
once in an unprovoked attack you were nearly murdered years ago. And after that you couldn't talk or sing for 2 years.
That's right.
So. Yeah. And then you became a heroin addict.
Well, I kind of did it at the same time as when I couldn't talk and sing. I thought I might as well do something interesting.
How did you manage to survive?
Well, I think in those kinds of circumstances, maybe a piece of you does die, but maybe that piece needs to die. So I think I survived by... what happened to me was, after kind of 2 years of this silence, one day I was just watching some children playing by a river in London, strangely enough, by the River Thames. And I just suddenly had heard a voice in my head say, I want my life back. So it was kind of like I had to just go through this big, big silent time after years and years of being in rock and being in loud places and shouting my bloody head off and being drunk and all of this. So it was a kind of good time in a strange way.
In retrospect, is there anything positive from this dark days, from those dark days that still might have an effect on you these days?
Yeah, I think so, because what it did was it meant that I spent a lot of time looking at people and listening to people, because I couldn't speak to people. I just spent a lot of time walking around and listening and noticing how the world works and how people are with each other. So it made me in a way into a camera, just kind of recording everything I was seeing and having nothing personal to say. So for me that was real good, because it gave me the beginnings of becoming a real storyteller, which I hope I am.
When I'm going nowhere, something here inside of me says I don't even care. Oh, and if yonder come my lady, rainbow ribbons in her hair, you know, she would be laughing with me as we move through the fair. I hear her calling from the mountain, hear her singing in the air. I hear her voice in every fountain, and she promised she'd be there. But now I'm empty in Soho Square. Soho Square. Oh yeah, Soho Square. The king is in his garden, but the warrior is so far from home. And as cold sunlight hits the statue, little boy walks down a country lane. Of his love and his pain. I hear her calling from the mountain, promised she'd be there. But now I'm empty in Soho Square. Soho Square. Drink espresso in the bar Italia. I dream of distant harbors and wild music under bright stars. And now my cup is empty and the afternoon is gray. You know, if I was a religious guy, if I was a religious guy, if I was a religious guy, I would fall down and pray. I hear her calling from the mountain, hear her. And I've been waiting so long. I've been waiting so long. Oh, and if yonder come my lady, she will be laughing. As we move through the fair, as we move through the fair. Thank you.
Did you ever take an explicit political stand in a song?
Well, I'm not particularly interested in talking about existing political positions. I grew up in a communist town in Scotland and was a real serious socialist for a long time. So my feeling is towards socialism, but I don't want to really write about that. What I want to write about is what happens to people, because I think what happens to people is going to happen anyway, regardless of whether they're living in Margaret Thatcher's Britain or Tony Blair's Britain or Gerhard Schroeder's Germany. So that interests me much more. And I also think politics is very unsexy, and I do want my work to kind of have a sexual tone.
If you could look inside my heart, you'd see a body without a soul. Deserted villages, forgetting me now, blowing in the cold. If you could look inside my heart, you'd see. If you could look It was the time of spring and song. The lilac had already been and gone. I had just returned from walking by the sound. I came back to the hotel where you turned and said to me, the white bars of heaven keep me from you. I know you're living in hell. What can I do? That's what she said on that day. White bars of heaven keep me from you. Ooh. I know you're living in hell. What can I do? I stood under the shattered stars and watched the drunks fall by. So strong. Though something in your kiss was all wrong. Now you say there's something wrong inside my mind. You're gonna let me go. You whisper from behind, white bars of heaven keep me from you. I know you're living in hell. What can I do? That's what she said on that day. White bars of heaven keep me from you. Forget me not, blowing in a cold.
God bless us all. We'll see you somewhere else. Thank you for coming out.